So Donald Trump is having a terrible afternoon, which is great for us. And the reason it's so terrible is he just found out his brand new company, his social media venture, is already under investigation. It hasn't even launched yet. It's failed to meet its first launch deadline. Trump has already had to go beg investors for additional money because it's failing. And before it even goes live, it's already under criminal investigation, largely for scamming and or defrauding current and potential investors. And this was started by Elizabeth Warren, who tipped off the SEC and other groups to say, look, this company isn't being honest with its merger plans and with its plans to investors, even though the plans are implemented. And so this clearly violates the law, because when you have a publicly traded company, you need to be honest with anybody investing or thinking about investing, because if they don't have all the information and the stock price goes down, you're essentially screwing them and they didn't have a choice. And so what this is all about is how Trump's company is launching in a different way than traditional companies, which gives a lot more potential gray area that Trump can use to screw people. It says here, SPACs, which has seen a boon as alternative to traditional IPOs, have come under growing scrutiny by regulators and lawmakers because of concerns that investors may not have enough information to understand the risks involved. Senator Elizabeth Warren last month asked the SEC to look into the Trump SPAC merger. She said in a letter that Digital World Acquisition Corp. may have violated securities rules by failing to disclose discussions it was having about merging with Trump Media and Technology Group. She cited a New York Times story that said the SPAC CEO was discussing the deal with Trump well before the company started trading on the NASDAQ in October, but they never told investors. And so whether people thought it was a bad business deal or whether they didn't want to do a deal because Trump was involved, it doesn't really matter. When you hide info from current and prospective investors, that is illegal under US law with financial and criminal penalties. And this is so Trump for a bunch of reasons. One, it's so typical that before a Trump company even opens shop, it's already doing crimes. That is peak Donald Trump. But it's also big here because, as noted, this type of company launch allows Trump and company to screw people in a way that traditional company launches on the stock market can't do as well. And so, of course, Trump would pick the way that would allow him to make as much money grifting his gullible supporters, investing money they can't afford to lose, and he would pick that way and screw people. And it's also very fitting because I noted this exact problem was going to happen when Trump announced this, that every business Trump has run until this point has been private. His Trump organization is a private company, and there are way less rules about how transparent you have to be with investors and with consumers, with the tax man, everyone, when you're a private company. You have a lot more leeway. And so when Trump announced a public company, myself and all these other analysts were saying, Trump does not have the desire or the ability to be honest enough to run a public company. He's almost certainly going to violate the law, and he already has. So keep an eye on this. The company isn't even open yet, and Trump is already screwing investors by lying to them. If you see this going forward, remember, Donald Trump only makes money through business via deceit, and that's the way he's going to do it. He's going to screw shareholders and leave them holding the bag.